Rembrandt just came out for mobile earlier this year and hasn't even been released for the desktop yet, but it's already time to talk about its successor, Phoenix. I first mentioned AMD's next-gen Phoenix APUs in my Q2 roadmap update video, but over the past weeks we've been getting a lot of new leaks and rumors, so I think it's time for a dedicated video about AMD's Phoenix. Let's take a look at what Phoenix actually is, how it fits into AMD's roadmap, and what we can expect technology and performance-wise. If the rumors turn out to be true, Phoenix offers something very special, something AMD hasn't done in its past APU iterations. With Phoenix, AMD might change both the CPU and GPU IP at the same time. Let me explain why this is such a big deal. Until now, AMD has only changed either the GPU or CPU architecture with any new APU release, but not both at the same time. If we take a look at AMD's Zen-based APUs, we can see a very conservative approach from AMD here. Raven Ridge started off the Zen-based APUs back in 2018 with Zen CPU cores and Vega graphics. Over the next years, AMD never changed the graphics IP but only upgraded the CPU cores. Picasso offered Zen Plus cores and Vega. Vanillaware made the switch to Zen 2 but still used the same old Vega GPU. Cezanne introduced Zen 3 with, you guessed it, Vega. Only with Rampart, AMD finally ditched Vega for the much improved RDNA 2 architecture. But the CPU cores are still Zen 3 based, well, Zen 3 Plus to be more specific, but you get my point. AMD's progress was very methodically, not taking any risks. A little bit like Intel's TikTok approach back in the day. But Phoenix is supposed to break with AMD's previous strategy. Truly like a bird reborn out of its own ashes, Phoenix is set to use AMD's next-gen Zen 4 CPU cores in combination with next-gen RDNA 3 graphics, promising a huge performance jump in only one generation. Here's what a fully enabled Phoenix APU could offer if we take all the current rumors and leaks into account. A monolithic SoC using TSMC's N5 process, with up to 8 Zen 4 CPU cores, integrated RDNA 3 graphics with 1536 shaders, low power DDR5 or even low power DDR5X memory support, possible PCI Express Gen 5 support, and maybe a new FP8 socket for mobile and AIM5 for a future desktop release. There's currently some confusion as to how many shaders or compute units the integrated graphics in Phoenix will actually offer. I have read about anywhere from 16 to 24 compute units, and keep in mind that Rembrandt just made a huge jump in graphics performance with up to 12 RDNA 2 compute units. I think the confusion surrounding the compute unit and shader count is due to the differences between Vega, RDNA 1 and 2, and now RDNA 3. With Vega, AMD used a 4x SIMD design, short for single instruction multiple data. Thus, each Vega compute unit offered 4 SIMD units with 16 ALUs each, for a total of 64 shaders per compute unit. For example, a Cezanne-based APU with 8 Vega compute units has a total of 512 shaders. Now with RDNA and RDNA 2, AMD switched up the layout. Each compute unit now only offers 2 SIMDs, but now it's a 32 ALU design, which means RDNA and RDNA 2 offers the same 64 shaders per compute unit as Vega did, only in a 2x32 configuration instead of a 4x16. And then AMD also introduced a new term, the so-called workgroup, or WGP in short. A workgroup consists of 2 compute units, that's it. There's a really well-made tweet about it from Kepler, which illustrates the differences. If we translate all of that to the current gen Rembrandt, the iGPU has 12 compute units or 6 workgroups. And since Rembrandt is RDNA 2 based, which consists of 64 shaders per compute unit, the 12 compute units result in a total of 768 shaders. Now with RDNA 3, AMD is again making changes to the layout of the compute units. RDNA 3 is going back to the 4 SIMD setup, but keeps the 32 ALU design. As a result, RDNA 3 literally doubles the amount of shaders per compute unit. Instead of 2x32 with RDNA or an RDNA 2, now it's 4x32, so each compute unit has a whopping 128 shaders. That would mean if Phoenix actually offers 1536 shaders, which is double the shader amount of Rembrandt, it would still have the same amount of compute units, which kind of makes sense. AMD doesn't change the compute unit count, they just double the shaders in each compute unit. So all the rumors about 16 or even 24 compute units do not make a lot of sense in combination with the rumors that Phoenix will be RDNA 3 based, because 24 RDNA 3 compute units would be 3072 shaders, more than a RX 6700 XT. At this point, I have to put in a disclaimer. Please keep in mind that all these numbers are just based on current rumors. We don't know if Phoenix will actually use RDNA 3 or what exact compute unit or shader setup it will use. Maybe it will stick to RDNA2, in which case 24 compute units would make a lot of sense. But if the rumors are true and it's a RDNA3 design with 1536 shaders, Phoenix should offer the same 12 compute units as Rampart did, just with double the shaders. I think the GPU performance is the biggest point of interest for Phoenix, same as with Rembrandt. The integrated RX680M GPU in the Ryzen 6000 mobile chip made a huge performance jump for integrated graphics and offers 1080p medium gaming for a lot of games. Another huge performance jump about a year later could really elevate mobile and APU gaming in general. 8 Zen 4 CPU cores sound great, but we all know that the iGPU is the real star of the show. Aside from the compute unit and shader setup, there is another big question when it comes to Phoenix. Just increasing your graphics horsepower doesn't do much if you can't increase memory bandwidth at the same time. Rembrandt on the FP7 socket already supports low power DDR5, and while Phoenix might support higher clocked memory, it won't be double the bandwidth. We know AMD really likes to use a large cache to boost GPU and CPU performance. With RDNA 2, they introduced the Infinity Cache, which allows AMD to build their GPUs with a smaller memory interface, but still feed them with enough bandwidth. And the recent release of Zen 3D shows that more cache also helps CPU performance quite a lot, especially in games. So will we see Phoenix use an Infinity Cache to support the bandwidth needs of its integrated graphics? Paul from Red Gaming Tag, who first leaked the initial Infinity Cache for RDNA 2, said in one of his recent video that his sources told him Phoenix won't have Infinity Cache. Aside from Paul's usually pretty good sources when it comes to Radeon, I also think Infinity Cache on an APU doesn't make a lot of sense. Rembrandt also does not have it, even though it's RDNA 2 based and all other RDNA 2 GPUs have an Infinity Cache. The Infinity Cache concept is designed for dedicated GPUs, so you can save resources by implementing a smaller memory interface and still provide enough bandwidth. But neither Rembrandt nor Phoenix are using a smaller interface or slower memory. They will both use top-of-the-line low-power DDR5 memory. And a APU is more than just a GPU, AMD also has to design a cache that's helpful for CPU. I think Phoenix will most likely offer some kind of increased cache system, but more on a SoC level with larger L2 or L3 cache to support both CPU and GPU at the same time. A 3D V-cache option would be amazing here, but I think AMD will use 3D stacking only on chiplets for the foreseeable future, and Phoenix looks like another monolithic design. Maybe Phoenix doesn't cut the L3 cache in half like in all other recent mobile designs from AMD. Maybe the cache system gets a specific rework. I'm sure we will see some kind of cache magic, but most likely not something we would call Infinity Cache. Aside from the CPU and GPU architecture, there are a few rumors I'm not 100% convinced right now. AMD just made the switch to PCI Express Gen 4 with Rembrandt. I'm not sure if they will switch to PCI Express Gen 5 with Phoenix right away. The increased bandwidth isn't really needed yet, and especially on a mobile platform. It's a really big power hog, something you want to avoid. And then there is the supposed new FP8 socket. So far, AMD has used each socket for at least two generations. FP5 was used for Raven Ridge and Picasso, FP6 for Renoir and Cezanne, and AMD just made a switch to FP7 with Rembrandt in early 2022. A new FP8 socket for Phoenix only about a year later seems strange, especially since Rembrandt on FP7 already runs low-power DDR5 in PCI Express Gen 4. I think there's a decent chance that Phoenix will still use FP7, but that's just a pure guess on my part. AMD might very well introduce a new socket. Phoenix has a lot of potential to offer another huge step up in performance overall, but also especially when it comes to graphics. With 8 Zen 4 based CPU cores, 1536 RDNA 3 based GPU shaders, most likely a smart supportive cache system, and all of this on TSMC's 5 nanometer process, AMD has the potential to further increase their lead in APU performance. It's hard to accurately guess APU graphics performance this much in advance, especially since a lot of it is based on still unknown factors. Even if the shader count turns out to be true, performance would greatly depend on the actual clock speeds, the supported memory, and any kind of cache solution. With high clock, low power DDR5X and a large cache, Phoenix could deliver a lot more FPS than without it. I think it's possible that Phoenix will outperform a RX 6500 XT, but performance claims around a RX 6600 or even RTX 3060 sound a little too far-fetched to me. Keep in mind that even in a HS configuration, Phoenix is still an APU with probably a TDP of 35 watts. a RX 6600 has a TDP of 132 watts and combines a 224 gigabytes per second memory bandwidth with 32 megabytes of Infinity Cache. That's a lot more than even the most optimistic Phoenix estimates. Phoenix is rumored to be launched in early 2023 for mobile first, and then sometime later for AIM 5 on desktop. I really enjoy these early leaks and rumors, but keep in mind that's literally all we currently have. Rampant just came out for mobile and hasn't even launched for desktop yet, so we are talking about a product that's quite a bit in the future. Nonetheless, Phoenix is definitely something to keep your eye on, especially if you're interested in mobile and APU gaming performance. Just imagine what a Van Gogh successor that's the chip Valve is using for the Steam Deck would look like based on a Phoenix design, with 4 to 6 and 4 CPU cores and 8 RDNA 3 compute units, a Steam Deck 2 would be an absolute beast. Now, I would like to know what you think about Phoenix. Do you think AMD will actually switch both CPU and GPU IP at the same time? And how do you think AMD will solve the bandwidth issue? Write a comment down below with your take. I'm looking forward to it. As always, if you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button, subscribe for more content, and see you in the next video.